Hi there, Internet. My name's Court, and you've got courtside seats for my review of the brand new docuseries, The Beatles Get Back. Let's do it. The Beatles Get Back is a music documentary from director Peter Jackson and Disney+. The docuseries stars John Lennon, Paul McCartney, George Harrison, and Ringo Starr presented in archival footage. A documentary about the music group The Beatles featuring restored in-studio footage that was shot in early 1969 for the 1970 feature film Let It Be. I was looking forward to this docuseries very much. I'm a Beatles fan, I'm not a hardcore fan, I don't know the lyrics to every single song, but I really dig that band. And Peter Jackson? Yes, please. I haven't seen all of his work, but I love The Frighteners, really enjoyed King Long, and The Lord of the Rings are some of my favorite movies of all time. Didn't care for the Hobbit flicks, but I don't think I'm in the minority there. All of that said, I'm pretty mixed on this series. As I said, it's culled from 60 hours of mostly heretofore unseen footage shot during the Let It Be sessions, and draws from like another 150 hours worth of audio. I'll also say this, the restoration they did on the footage looks absolutely fantastic. So kudos to the team that did it, they crushed it, and the audio also sounds pretty immaculate. The film opens with a short sort of wrap-up of the band's career up until that point, almost like a Cliff's Notes, just to set context, thought that was great. And the series is presented in three different episodes. The first mainly concerns itself with the band trying to write new material in a TV studio where the initial plan is to record the album live with an audience. The second episode spends more time with the band as they've moved to a proper recording studio to hone the material. And then the final installment starts in that same studio and then transitions to the iconic rooftop concert, which was the first live show they'd played in like 2 years, much of which would be recorded live and used on Let It Be. And I'll admit, the third chapter was far and away my favorite of the three. And there are some absolutely fascinating moments in here. I don't think this counts as spoilers because this is all a matter of historical fact going back 40 years. We see Paul coming up with an early version of what would become Get Back, along with George and Ringo working out Octopus's Garden and Maxwell's Silverhammer. Of course, those would end up on Abbey Road, not Let It Be, but it's still really cool. We see George leaving the band and a sort of angry, frenetic jam in his absence that involves Yoko screeching into the mic. And we see George's eventual return. One of the highlights for me was the working out of I've Got a Feeling, which is a song that I absolutely love. And we see recordings of songs like Let It Be and I Just Like This, Paul interacting with his adorable adopted daughter, Heather. That was all great. It's fun to watch the band being goofy and jamming on traditionals and classics. It's also kind of distressing, but also fascinating to watch them bicker with one another. And the footage of the rooftop concert can't be beat. It's an incredibly candid look into one of the most iconic bands of all time. Having said that, with all of the good that there is in here, this series is punishingly long. With the three episodes combined, this thing clocks in at nearly 8 hours. Much as I love Jackson, and I do, the man is not known for brevity. Perhaps if they had broken it down into 8 hour-long episodes, it would have been easier to digest. But the first episode is like 2.5 hours, the second one's 3, the third one's like 2 hours and 20 minutes, and it's a lot. There's also a lot in here that felt pretty unnecessary to me. Long conversations about how the room has bad acoustics. I get that that's an important thing to talk about, but it felt like that conversation went on for like 20 minutes. Did we need all of that? I certainly didn't. A couple of minutes would have got the point across. And conversations like that is a lot of the first episode. It just kind of goes on and on. I get the impulse to have 60 plus hours of footage of what many consider to be the best band of all time, like at your fingertips, and to not want to have to edit anything out. But I feel like this thing would have been a lot better with some judicious editing. For me anyway, I think this could easily have been like a 3.5 hour documentary, and it probably would have been actually more impactful. Just get all the good bits together. The way it's presented, it comes across as pretty self-indulgent, and for me anyway, it felt like a bit of a chore to get through. I do think that this docuseries will be absolutely fascinating for Beatles purists and completionists. I think they'll be hanging off every second. But for more casual fans like myself, it's probably way too much. Now, I don't have a proprietary rating system as of yet, so I'm just trying to figure out what I'm gonna give The Beatles Get Back, and I think I'm gonna give The Beatles Get Back a...
It's been done.
...out of 10. So now, I wanna know, have you seen The Beatles Get Back? What did you think about it? What's your favorite Beatles song of all time? Whatever your thoughts, hit the comments below. Let's discuss. If you enjoyed this review, please smash that like button and give it a share if you really enjoyed it. It just helps the video reach more people, helps the channel grow, I appreciate it very much. And hey, why not take a second, do me a favor, click subscribe and ring that bell to subscribe to my channel for more movie reviews, entertainment news, trailer reactions, all that good stuff. For my American friends, I wish you guys a very happy Thanksgiving. Hope you guys are all safe and healthy. Thanks very much for watching. I will see you all in the next one. Take care.